I tell myself it's me. I have told myself so many times I can speak the words without opening my mouth. I tell myself I'm missing parts I never deserved. I tell myself my soul is filthy, broken, and stained, redeemed by the bruises that ride and spread like lovers on my back. I turn off the lights, turn from the mirrors, avert my gaze from powers and prayers I tell myself I'm too soiled to understand. And I tell myself it's me. But on a cool, quiet night, when the bills are paid, there's fresh bread and cheese, when I feel centered as a candle flame, I've discovered my sky fills with stories, true stories, like eager songbirds, clean and bright. And if you can be still, they lose their fear. They land on you, like your lover's voice on a nursery rhyme, and they sing. But when they get scared and fly off, it's a perfect prom night ending, the screen door slamming, your drunk daddy snoring with dark with the TV still on. And you've caught your skirt in the jam, and try not to stumble, hoping he doesn't look up. Because if you can just get to your room and close the door, maybe you can look at yourself without fear one last time through your own eyes. Sometimes I look at myself and say, what the hell am I thinking? Too many parts broken, too many parts whole, yet somehow missing parts. I touch my legs and hear my mother, who told me not to believe my scars. I touch my lips and hear my father and all the reasons he made up so he could hit me. I hear both those voices forcing my body to tell myself it's me. With my empty breasts rising and my sperm count falling, I am left with no milk of any sort. How can I nourish anything? Where's my fertility? Where's my motherhood? When you're too broken to pray, not worth being saved, you work with the voices you have. The magic fades, you're so tired, stupid. Nothing matters, nothing's real anyway. Not your pain, your thoughts, your body, especially not yourself. Oh, I'd like to believe there's a heaven or creator, but when can I stop creating that belief and just glide on my faith and soar? Forget prophecy, forget the crystal ball. I want a cartwheel in a kaleidoscope, tumble with the divine in bright, jagged contradictions that cut so deep you can press your ear against their bellies and never hear a cry. Then you recall, not the bedroom door flying open, but a reflection, a scent. Like the first time you rode an airplane or smelled a field of strawberries. A story you didn't have to learn because it's truly your own. One night, my girlfriend and I were driving my pickup to Arizona. It was raining and the windshield was streaky, so we couldn't drive safely. We pulled into a late night Autostar to find replacement blades. The salesman saw us look and grunted, well, these are what you want. But we went back to the truck and they weren't even close. So we stood there, silent in the rain. But then we nodded, went back, returned his stupid blades and found a pair I thought I could jury-rig. The rain was coming down hard, but I told Steph, don't worry, I think I can do this. I pried out the old blades, loosened the brackets, and slid the new ones in. And we were off. And I think of a femme Asian tranny dyke who can tell a car parts salesman he's wrong in the middle of a stormy desert night and change a pair of windshield wipers that aren't supposed to fit. I think of someone worried about her hair getting frizzy in the rain, even as she says the cut on her hand is no big deal. I think of someone asking if she's turning butch, even as she frets over her eyeliner in the rearview mirror of an old pickup truck on its way to Arizona. And then I tell myself, it's me. As I take another pill, get another day older, and all I've managed is to live a little longer in a world I can't find a place in. That I might be more than a pill or a syringe or memories or scars. That I was made in the image of someone who said her body is okay as it is, but stays up nights wondering what it would be like to carry a child. That my creator is too big to buy clothes off the rack, worries about which bathroom to use at the mall. That my creator has rolled a pack of Virginia Slims ultralight menthols in a t-shirt sleeve, fixed her eyeliner with a lick Q-tip, and changed a tire in a velvet waistcoat and platform shoes. And I tell myself, it's me. Sometimes, when you've been with someone for a while, you can forget why you're even there. But if you're lucky, one day or one night, you might catch that girl at the corner of your eye, as if from a distance or by accident, and see that person, almost as a stranger, for the first time. And I wonder how many times, how many trips to Arizona each of us has made, what windshield wipers we've changed, the songs we've landed in the hearts of our friends, and how many times we've missed the chance to hear the true stories we speak to the world, and fall in love with who we are, almost as strangers, first time, all over again.